Hello and welcome to my Minecraft tutorial. This is episode number 32 in my How to Survive and Thrive series. And in today's episode, we are going to embark on a mission, a quest of great import, of epic proportion and magnitude. Yes, indeed, my friends, we will quest for the long-forgotten Minecraft mushroom. Long abandoned, shunned, and made practically obsolete in a version or two ago. And in honor of the mushroom, today we will seek one out and I will show you some of the uses that they still have. Right down there in that cave is the last few mushrooms known to mankind, Minecraft kind, and we shall set forth and restore some of their honor. Let us go. I must warn you that this journey will be dangerous and fraught with peril. The road may be blocked by the anti-mushroom minions that will try to stop us in our quest to restore the honor of the Minecraft mushroom. How's that for romantic melodrama? So, let's get on with the tutorial, shall we? Yes, the Minecraft mushroom. It used to have quite a number of uses and a lot more purpose than it does now, I should say. Sadly, with the introduction of something called huge mushrooms, and of course the new hunger bar, mushrooms have lost some of their, popularity, and efficiency, and use, and everything that comes with the old mushroom, the old standby. So what we're going to do is head down here and gather a few mushrooms. Now, I've done a little bit of scouting here. I do know that one patch exists right down here. It's awfully dangerous. So if you are following along, just do as I do and be prepared for fight. Aha. He's one of the anti-mushroom minions now. Just stay the course. Stay true. And you will be victorious. My original intentions when I came down here was not looking for mushrooms. It was looking for diamond. Because I really want to do an enchantment tutorial. We want to make an enchantment table. And enchant weapons and armor and tools and so forth. And use some of these experience levels that we have gained down below there. It says 18 before I die. But I need 2 diamonds for that. So on my search for diamonds, I located... Somebody's hurt. I located these mushrooms. Oh, he's fighting with somebody else. May I watch? Oh! Wow. A little misfire there. Okay, well, here are the mushrooms. As you can see, they do grow in the dark places. You'll find them underground occasionally. Here and there, there are 2 varieties, a red and a brown. And... oh dear me, do not fall down there. Obviously we have the red variety here. You can take them with anything you want. Zombie flesh works perfectly fine. A hand, a fist, a sword. You can even put a torch next to them and they'll pop right off. Because they do not like light. And back in the day, alpha and beta, we could farm these mushrooms. That's when they had a real use. Mushroom stew, which is what we're going to make here shortly, would heal 4 health. This is before the hunger bar was introduced. And mushroom stew was the best food money could buy. So you are always on the lookout for mushrooms, indeed. Aha, here they come. More minions of the darkness. Goodbye to you, sir. Now, I have red mushrooms. I could have sworn there was some brown down here, too. Remember? Torches on the right. Here we go. And if you want to follow along, you can download this map. Excellent, excellent. And you will find the same, the very same mushrooms in the very same location. There might be a slight variation depending on what version your map is made in. But if you download this one from my site, I'll have a link in the description. You'll get this very map. And that looks like it goes all the way around. And here's our double torch, so we know our way out. Look at that, right around in a circle. Let's get out of here. What did we get? How was the haul? Yeah, 16 red and 5 brown. Quickly, back to the surface. Hey, a little role play makes tutorials a lot more fun, don't you think? Oh no, it's raining! That means I have to yell over the rain. Yeah. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to head back over here to the home site, and I'm going to show you some of the uses of mushrooms. I think I may get indoors and take a quick nap and see if I can't get rid of the rain, because I don't want to do this in the rain. In fact, I may do that. So sometimes when you sleep, you'll sleep right through the rain. If it's nighttime, I can sleep. If not, we're in trouble. All right, zombie flesh I'm going to store away for the dogs. And so we have... Why don't we do this? Let me turn down that volume just a tad here. That ought to do. All right. And I'll show you what we can do with this guy. So why don't we take our wooden planks. We can make bowls like this. So 3 wooden planks arranged like so. We'll get you 4 wooden bowls. If you put a bowl in your inventory or the crafting bench, a red mushroom and a brown mushroom, and you can arrange them any way you desire, you'll get a mushroom stew. Unfortunately, your mushroom stew, if you make another, they do not stack. That's a leftover penalty from the old days of alpha and beta, because it was such a powerful food that just didn't want to get all stocked up on them. But here's one of the other reasons it's been kind of made rendered obsolete, is you can stack any other kind of food except for the mushroom stew, despite the fact that the mushroom stew doesn't restore any more food bars than regular meat. So yeah, it's a little bit of a shame. I like my mushroom stew. So that's pretty much it for mushroom stew. So I'm going to store the stew away over here. We don't need it. Oh, by the way, I did a lot of harvesting, and you should be doing the same. We're going to need, well, for the sugarcane anyway, we're going to need a lot of paper for the next tutorial or two. When we get that other diamond anyway, we're going to need this for paper for the bookshelves for enchanting. All right, I think I'm going to take a quick nap and try to get rid of that rain. So you can try the same. I'll be right back. All right, I'm back. The rain has stopped. Unfortunately, I think I'm in a really rainy biome here. I get a lot of rain in this spot. Wouldn't you say, doggy? Yes. So why don't we do this? I'm going to show you one of the other uses, and let's hop on the boat for this. I'm going to go over to that little outcropping or island. I don't think it's quite an island, actually. And we're going to call this Mushroomville or Mushroom Island. I think it's... Is it an island? No, it's not an island. I don't think it does. I think it does have a little connected... Yes, it does. Okay, anyway, let's clear this out. And I'm going to show you one of the best uses of a mushroom of all time. Sadly, it does make some of the other uses obsolete. But I'm going to show you what you can do with this guy. So, this is called my portable emergency shroom shelter. And what you do is you want to carry a mushroom with you, or two, some bone meal. It doesn't matter which color. I think the red is probably the best. It's going to make the best shelter. And a ladder and a wooden door if you'd like. You don't need the wooden door, but you need at least one piece of dirt, some ladders, bone meal, and the mushroom. And I'm going to show you exactly how this works now. All right, let's find a little spot right here. And you can put your mushroom down. Why don't we do a brown first? And I'll just demonstrate what bone meal does to a mushroom. Place it down on the ground. It has to be on grass or dirt. And you right click and bingo! Giant mushroom. That's a giant brown mushroom. And there's nothing small about that. So that is kind of cool. And you can take your axe and you can bust right through this. Actually, you can just use a fist or anything, really, because they break up extremely easily. And here's why farming mushrooms been made. Rendered obsolete. When you break down the mushroom, there's a chance each block will drop another mushroom. So as you can see, I'm getting a whole bunch here falling from the sky. So much for Minecraft mushroom farming. Brings a tear to my eye, truly. Oh well. I'll get the rest of that here momentarily. Let's find another spot. In fact, let's get rid of that. And now I'm going to show you something with the red mushroom. The red mushroom, when it pops open, is a little bit different. This is why I call this the emergency shelter. So let's say you're running scared. Things are chasing you. The anti-mushroom army. And here's how you rub it in their faces. Excuse me. Here they come. Oh no! Boom! Goodbye, anti-mushroom folks. Ha-ha! And now they're just wandering around. They're like, where did he go? Which way did he go, boss? Which way did he go? I am now inside a red mushroom. So there! Anti-mushroom attack force, or whatever they are. And now to get out of here, we just pop. And now I have an instant portable emergency shroom shelter. Some people call them portable instant shroom shelter, but I'm not crazy about that acronym. Yes, the P-E-S-S. So there's that. Now, what else can we do with these guys? Well, if I break this down, I'm going to get red mushrooms, but I don't want to do that because I want to make a mushroom village. Oh, by the way, if you dig down that hole and you put the mushroom down in it, there may be a gap here. It's random. It's either going to be one high up above. It might even go two, or it may go right to the ground like it did there. But let me show you. Beat it. See? Everybody is out to stop me. Even the spy chickens. Nobody likes these. Oh, yeah, and you might take a punch in the face, too. So there's another red mushroom. As you can see there, we have this one's a little bit higher off the ground. And what we can do there, let's make another one over here. This is going to be a whole little village. Now, you do need some space for this. So if it doesn't pop instantly like that, that means something is in the way. Something's obstructing that instant growth. And we can't have that now, can we? All right, so now let's put another one down. And let's see if we can get... Yeah, tall one. That's the one I was looking for. Okay, so now, because that one went right to the ground, I didn't need my ladders, but let's say still being chased by the anti-Minecraft mushroom force right up. Oh, you should have platforms too, I think. And climb, and shift. Why am I not climbing and shifting? There we go. And then you can make a little hidey place. And it looks like I need a ladder. Man, they keep changing ladders on me. By the way, in the next patch, the ladders will have their hitbox back again. They took it away for a while. And there we have a little mushroom house. I feel like Papa Smurf. This is Smurfalicious. Ah, Smurf it. You're so Smurfy. Every other word is like Smurf. All right, so now we have our little Smurfalicious home here. And I'm going to make a little window, I believe. Oh, wait. Well, I might just make a door. Let's make a door. The window would be too high. So, oh, dear. All right, well, that'll be a window. That'll be a nice tall window. Let the sun shine in. Let the sun shine in. And there's a window to look out. And I might put my door on the other side. And then connect all these together. With little catwalks. Wooden catwalks between them. Mushroom village! Survival? Not really. I guess the portable emergency shroom shelter certainly can help you survive in a pinch if you need to escape something chasing you. Or if you're in the nether, for example, which we will be heading to very, very soon. It makes a nice shelter, quick shelter. But it's still fun. Minecraft is also about fun and building, and this, I guess, would qualify for thriving. So I'm going to go ahead and make a whole bunch of little more mushrooms. I'll put some browns and more reds, connect them all together, and have a little mushroom village. Good, clean, fun. Spies, who needs them? So that's my tribute to mushrooms. Oh, and while we're here, let's make a mushroom stew. Since I'm hungry And I'm, you know what? I'm going to have mushroom stew. Take that, roast chicken. Mm-hmm. Ah. Oh, by the way, you get the bowl back. So there's another reason you can carry it. Now, if you're going for a long, epic journey down in a mine shaft and, you know, there's not a lot of food down there, a handful of mushrooms, red, brown, and a bowl, you could live for a long, long time. So there. More good stuff about the mushrooms. I believe this episode is through. I think this mission is complete, and we have been victorious and successful in restoring the honor of the Minecraft mushroom. I'm going to make a brown over here. Now that grass might be in the way. No? Okay. There we go. Nice. That's just one big old platform. And, oh, and next time I think we're going to go down and get that diamond. We're going to get some diamonds. We're going to make the enchantment table. Oh, dear me. You dropped something. We will make the enchantment table, and we're going to enchant tools and weapons and armor. When we enchant the a tool, you might get something called, enchantment called Silk Touch. And what Silk Touch allows us to do is it will allow us to take these blocks just as they are. So rather than them being destroyed and yielding a mushroom, it's going to yield that actual block so we can use it for building. So we'll be able to fill in some of the gaps here, like, thanks for the breakfast. Like that one right there, because it looks a little silly, I'll be able to put another one up top. Because these things, you can never actually harvest these red blocks. You'll never get them unless you're in creative mode or you cheat somehow. But the Silk Touch enchantment on a tool will allow us to get any block, really. Like an ore, if you wanted just a coal ore, for example, without getting the coal. All right, well, I hope you enjoyed. I know this wasn't anything spectacular, but next time we're going to go down and get that diamond. And we'll be rocking and rolling again with enchantment. And then we're going to head down to the Nether. We'll bring a portable emergency shroom shelter with us, just to be on the safe side. And rub it into the anti-mushroom army face. So there. All right. Take care. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye. Ha. I fooled you. You can't get rid of me that easily. There is one more thing, actually, I forgot to mention. And you can indeed farm mushrooms. And it's basically just plant it somewhere, and it will attach to most surfaces, actually. But it has to be dark. It's not going to be good on the surface. You've got to put it in a cave somewhere or in a building where the light is very low. And it will eventually spread out in a small area, and then you can go and pluck them. Unfortunately, there's really no point to doing that, since we can just grow an instant mushroom and then harvest the mushrooms from it. But I thought I should mention that. And also one other thing, brown mushrooms are indeed used in a recipe, in a brewing recipe. And we'll probably get to that in the future, but red mushrooms, they don't really, excuse me, red mushrooms still don't really have much of a use other than making huge mushrooms and making stew. So anyway, there you go. I hope you enjoyed. And this is the final goodbye for this episode. Bye-bye. Thanks for watching.